First, there was light. Light, please! Have you ever seen a car with just one working light? In the dark, it looks like a motorcycle, which could be dangerous. Now imagine that suddenly both lights go out. Blackout! Blackout! It is extremely dangerous for you as well as for all the other people on the road. Major accidents could happen that could bring irreversible damage. Now imagine stoplights, traffic lights, all of the lights. Stop lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights. Suddenly break down. This could result in a major carpocalypse. Endless traffic jams, not to mention the stress, the fights, maybe even potential wars. Okay, stop light. Have you ever wondered how the lights are tested to assure sustainability and reliability? One of the fields Slovenian Institute of Quality SIQ focuses on is the issue of car and traffic lights, which helps minimize the accidents in the transport industry. Now, let's shine a little light on the process of how car lights are tested. Let's go.
Enlightenment time. So I'm sitting here with Mr. Gregor Schoss. He's the department manager at the SIQ. We'll talk about the lights today. So how do you test the lights, and does the testing move slowly or does it go with the speed of light?
Yeah, it's going a little bit slowly. There are several tests needs to be observed, up to 100 different tests. After these tests are finished, you can say, yes, this light is okay to put it on the market.
So what kind of lights do you test?
We are testing many different lights. One is a clear example, this is medical light. Then we do the testing of street lights. We do the testing also of LED lights inside of the cars. In the past, tests were very simple. For example, for such bulbs, there are only 15 different tests. But at LED, now we need to perform more and more tests, and the tests are more and more complex.
The future is becoming more and more complex. For example, in 1970s, the whole car consisted of 2,000 parts. Nowadays, you have 10,000 parts only in the light, and self-driving cars are on the run, so additional testing will be needed.
So let's say, when a manufacturer provides you a light, how many days or months does it take from 0 point to the finish point that you say, okay, the certification is okay, you can have a CE mark on it?
Yeah, for example, for such easy bulb, yeah, we need 2 days, right? Now we need a month, maybe sometimes 2 or 3. Depends how complex light it is. You need to observe, like you mentioned, safety testing, EMC testing, performance testing, and many, many tests.
Some of the biggest car manufacturers in the world test their car lights at SIQ. Their lights are a product of long-lasting development. Every company has their own secret when it comes to manufacturing, so trust is essential when it comes to testing, so that the secrets would not break out. At SIQ, all the partners are considered equal, and that's very important, because money doesn't play a role, because by nature, this is a non-profit institute. Brake lights! Okay, just to see if you are still here. Green light, let's go. So there you have it, dear friends. I hope you enjoyed learning about car lights testing. I hope that when you turn on the lights in your car next time, you'll remember the process they had to go through to meet the criteria. And don't stress out too much when you have to stop and wait at the red light. It took so much more time to develop and test the light than how long you have to wait. Just behold and admire the technology and testing made by developer and SIQ. At the end, the very light that makes you stop and wait prevents catastrophic accidents. Be thankful. Okay, green light, let's go. If you like science, how things work and how they are tested, don't forget to click subscribe with the bell aside for more cool videos. Thank you for watching. See you!